There's an old saying, a phrase that is used. I'm sure you've heard it, maybe even said it yourself. That phrase is this, take five. It means to stop for a moment to catch your breath and regroup before getting back into the action. That's what I'm asking you to do right now. Stop what you're doing and take 5 minutes to let the Word of God breathe new life into you and allow the Spirit of God to grant you your second wind, to not only face the journey ahead of you, but to finish strong. The clock is already ticking, so let's get started. When I was young, I had no idea what I wanted to be when I grew up. In my teens and even late teens, I still struggled with the idea. I didn't have this sense of knowing what I was to be, like some seem to have. It wasn't until I was an adult before I realized what my true purpose was. In Luke chapter 2, we read of a story where Jesus, being 12 years old, went up to Jerusalem with his family to celebrate the feast of Passover. And when everyone began to make their way back to Nazareth, he stayed behind in Jerusalem. After a day's journey, Mary and the others realized that he wasn't with them, and so they turned back. They come back to Jerusalem, and after 3 days, they find him. And lo and behold, he was in the temple talking with the doctors and lawyers concerning things of the scripture and of the Lord. Now, Mary seems to rebuke Jesus at this point and asks, well, why did you do this? We've been searching for you sorrowfully. And Jesus' response hit me. He says, how is it that you sought me? Wished you not that I must be about my Father's business? Jesus had a divine plan and purpose for his life. His very name, Jesus, means Jehovah saves. Now, at this point, you might be pushing back a little and saying, well, yeah, Gordon, but that's Jesus. But Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5, the Lord says of Jeremiah, and he's of no respecter of persons, he says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. He says, and before thou camest forth from the womb, he says, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet to the nations. The Lord has a plan and a purpose for our lives, too. Whether we're students, doctors, lawyers, pastors, business owners, accountants, construction workers, retired, whatever it is that we do, if we're disciples of Christ, then we should be about our Father's business. That's what it's about. In John chapter 2, Jesus says to his brothers, he says, mine hour is not yet. Jesus functioned at the Father's timetable. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, we're told that there's a time and a season for everything under heaven. If we're going to be about the Father's business, we've got to be on the Father's time card. In John chapter 8, Jesus says, I only do those things that please the Father. Paul says in Romans 12:1 that we should present our bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. And he says we're to be transformed so that we can prove what is that good, acceptable, perfect will of God. If we're going to be about the Father's business, then we're going to have to do those things that please him. In John chapter 10, Jesus says, I and my Father are one. He later prays in John 17 that you and I, his disciples, would be one with them. We need to learn to be on the same page. We need to be about the purpose the Father has for us. In John chapter 12, Jesus says, I only say those things that please the Father. And we should let our words be with grace, seasoned with salt. We need to say those things that are pleasing to the Lord. In John 12 and 14, Jesus says, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. In Ephesians 5:1, we're told to be imitators of God as dear children. If we're going to be about the Father's business, then we are to represent the Father. Jesus says in John 17, Father, I have glorified thy name. And Paul tells us in Corinthians that whether we eat or drink or whatever we do, we should do for the glory of God. In John chapter
4 and in chapter 19. In 4, Jesus says, my meat is to do the will of the one that sent me and to finish his work. In John 19:30, he says, it is finished. He finished the Father's work. It involved the cross, and the Father's work for us involves the cross. Jesus says, if any man come after me, in Luke 9:23, he must take up his cross daily and follow me. Paul says, I have finished the course. I have finished the work the Father has given me. In Matthew 26, Jesus is praying in the garden, Father, if there's any way, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. And this caused me to think about the way Jesus told us to pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What's your role in the Father's business? Whatever that is, you need to be about it, because that is why you're here.
Hey guys, be sure to click like and subscribe if this video helped you. And most importantly, share it with someone you think would benefit from a spiritual breather themselves. God bless you. I'll catch you on our next break.